So hello guys, welcome back to the channel everyone. So guys, in this video I will show you how you can remove or delete all kind of cache files and cache data from your system. I will show you 9 types of cache data, right? You have different kind of cache data stored in your RAM, but you don't know about that and how we can clear that. So why applications or Windows is storing cache data? So whenever you open any kind of application in your system, then in the first time it will store some kind of cache data in your RAM, and in the second time when you open that application, it will open more quickly than previous one. Sometimes this can be cause a problem for your system, like slowing down your system and freezing and all that stuffs are going on. So it is good to clear some kind of cache data from your system, right? And it is not harmful. Some people thinking like deleting cache data will remove all kind of my personal data and like images, photos and all that, but it is not. So don't worry about that. So follow all these steps whatever I'm going to show. So if you are new on this channel, do subscribe and hit the bell icon for the latest update and good quality of videos. Okay, so let's start the video and see what are these cache datas, right? So first is clearing file explorer cache data, right? So what it is like, whenever you open your this PC and open any folder and all that, so it takes some time and sometimes it is stuck. And if it is happening, like you think your file explorer is not working properly, not opening quickly, so you can just clear file explorer cache. And it's not complicated, it's very simple. Just click on view and you can see here options. Just click on it. You can see change folder and search option. Just click on it. So for clearing cache data of file explorer, you can see here clear file explorer history. Just clear this and apply. Okay, and after following all steps, just restart your system and you will see very good change in your system, right? So next is DNS cache data, right? So you need to clear your DNS cache data. Like, so after time to time, whenever you're using your internet and if you are facing any kind of problem with your internet, and you can just clear your DNS cache data. It's very helpful for your internet speed, right? So for that, you need to do here. Just go here and search for CMD and run as administrator. So here you need to type /flushdns and hit enter. So now you can see a message, successfully flushed the DNS resolver cache. So the next is clearing the Windows App Store cache data, right? Whenever you open your Windows App Store and you feeling like it is crashed and all that, if shit happen with that app, you can just clear that cache data, because they are giving some exe file for clearing the cache of your Windows App Store. So you need to press Windows plus R and type here wsreset.exe. And press enter, and it will open this CMD command. So after clearing a store cache, and it will open that app. So now you can see the Microsoft Store is open and it's just clear that cache data, and now it will work perfectly fine. You can see scrolling is smooth and whatever the problem is going behind it, so that will fix. So the next is clearing the Windows update cache. So this can be a very big change for your system. Like after time to time, whenever you are updating your system, you are not clearing cache data of your update, right? So this can be a huge, but I'm clearing all the time, so that's why in my case it will not be very huge. So for that, you need to click on this PC and go to here C drive, and in Windows you need to press S and look for software distribution folder. Click here and go to here downloads and select all and right click and delete. Okay, and the next one is clearing the system restore point cache data. That can be a very helpful if you are making restore point before doing any settings and all that, so it can be very huge for your system, right? So if you don't know about what is restore point, so let me show you. Just right click here and go to properties, click on advanced system settings and go to system protection. So whenever you are changing any setting for your system, you can just create a restore point and name it whatever it is, and you can see your system restore point. So whenever you want to restore and something should happen with your system, you can just restore. So let me show you the cache data of a restore point. Click configure. So now you can see in my case it's 6.72 GB, but in your case it can be a 0 byte and it can be a very huge, like 10 to 20 GB and all that. So for that, just click on delete all restore point for this drive, delete and continue. And now you can see here we can also free up space in your hard disk. So this is a very good thing you need to do. So just click OK and OK. So the next catch is temporary file which you are already used, but now let me show you how we can clear temp file. And there are multiple temps, so you need to just watch what I'm doing. Like press Windows plus R and you need to type here only temp, T-E-M-P, and just select all, right click and delete. Again press Windows plus R and type here percent, T-E-M-P percent. Hit enter and now you can see here. And if you are using your system from a long time and you haven't cleared any kind of cache from your system, then definitely your system is very slow. So you need to definitely follow these steps and you will see the change, right? Again press Windows plus R and type here prefetch. In my case it's not huge, but if you haven't restarted your system from a long time, then you will see here lots of data, right? And just select all and delete, and don't worry about this, will not cause any kind of problem. And the next cache data is disk cleanup. This can be a game changing for your system. So just click on this PC. In disk cleanup, you can clear all kind of temporary files and you can say you can free up more space in your disk. So right click here and go to properties. So if you are not deleting any kind of previous update from your Windows, like windows.old folder and all that, you can delete from here. So just click on disk cleanup. It will fetch all kind of cache and show you. So just check all the boxes and uncheck download folder if you have. In my case it's not showing, but you can see here 873 MB. Okay, I'm usually clearing cache data, so that's why it's showing very less. In your case can be a huge, like 200 GB. So just click OK and delete file. So okay, and close it. So the next is the location cache data. So yeah, definitely you don't know about it. Press Windows plus I, open Windows setting. This is a shortcut key. Go to privacy and scroll down a little bit. You can see here location, and you can see here clear location history on this device. Just clear, and if you are using map in your Windows, that can be a very good change for your system. Clear that and see the change. And the next is web browsing cache data, right? So if you are using Chrome and Mozilla Firefox, even Microsoft Edge, so you need to clear that cache data within a month if you want your system work perfectly. So let me open this Chrome. Same thing you need to follow for other browsers. Go here three dots and click settings and scroll little bit. Like if you are facing problem with Chrome not scrolling perfectly and not opening quickly, so you can just clear all cache from your Chrome browser. So they already given a setting, you can just click on that. You can see here clear browsing data, click on it. You can see check all this. If you don't want to delete browsing history, you can uncheck them. Go to advanced, and in advanced you can see downloaded history and all that. I don't want to delete the browsing history. Okay, I want to delete only cache. You can see image file, so uncheck this password and autofill and uncheck this hosted app data. So just clear data. You will see a very drastic change in your Chrome browser and after restarting your system and opening this Chrome. Okay, so this will be a very good for you. So after following these steps, whatever I'm showing in video, and if you are a gamer and a normal user, then you will see a very good change in your system, and you can say you can improve your and increase your productivity, right? Follow this, and if you want to optimize your system, you can watch my other videos. So now it's clear all cache, and just restart your system and you will see a very good change. So guys, these are the 9 steps and 9 kind of cache data you can clear and make your system very good and speed up. Okay, so guys, that's it for the video. If you like this video, just hit the like button and do subscribe for more videos. Okay, thank you so much for watching this video.